Hello, hello, hello. This is Rich Kale here on YouTube, Rich Gen X elsewhere, and it is time for us to continue the escapades of Sherlock Holmes against gentleman thief Arsene Lupin. Now, if you recall, we resumed the game right here. At National Gallery of Painting. So let's talk with the gentleman here.
Good afternoon, gentlemen, and welcome to the National Gallery of Painting. As it's such a lovely day outside, you're the only visitors at the moment, and likely will be for the whole day, as the minimum number of people for a guided tour is...
We're not here to visit the museum, young man. My name is Sherlock Holmes, and this is my friend and colleague, Dr. Watson.
Sherlock Holmes? The famous detective?
Indeed. I have reason to believe that a theft is being planned that will take place here, perhaps as early as today.
A robbery?
Yes.
I'm not certain, but there is a good reason to believe that is the case. We have contacted Inspector Lestrade at Scotland Yard, and he should be joining us momentarily. Meanwhile, rest assured that we are here in an official capacity. In the meantime, you can certainly help us. One of the paintings will play a part in the matter, but I don't yet know exactly which one. I do, however, have a few clues that should tell something to a specialist like yourself.
Ah, yes, of course. As it happens, I've only been working here for 3 days.
Oh.
Actually, I'm an apprentice, and my duties here are essentially administrative.
Pray tell, would I be correct in deducing that the elder of the two men that we can see up there is the director of the museum?
Yes, that is Sir Poynter. He could certainly assist you better than I, but at the moment he's terribly occupied and will be for some time.
But the location that you are proposing is unworthy of my work. All of my pieces are hymns to color and light. It's the very stars, the sun that you want to extinguish.
Please understand, dear sir, the entrance hall is reserved for temporary exhibitions. We are able to add more lighting.
In that case, you would have to provide lanterns across the whole length of the ceiling and to use the most refined oil possible. Definitely not gas. And mirrors to reflect the light, along with some canvases in basic colors to bring out the contrasts.
We will do all that we possibly can.
Nevertheless, I insist that a number of my works must be on the main floor next to the large pieces.
But our rooms are already full and, as you know, each has its specific subject. Too much modernism?
How can there be too much modernism? Modernism doesn't exist. Only art exists. Art is timeless. Art is cosmic.
Well, sir, perhaps we should continue this conversation in my office.
Okay.
Then you must certainly have a ledger of the works that are shown in the museum, with a description of each painting.
Yes, Sir Poynter entrusted it to my care this morning, so I could familiarize myself with the collection, but I lost it. I know, I make a rather feeble archivist, but while I was doing a tour of the museum, the painting that Mr. Poynter is now dealing with arrived, along with cases full of canvases that he had to quickly inventory.
The case of the missing ledger. What do you make of it, Watson? Listen, Mr...
Palliner, sir.
Palliner, my friend and I will make our way through the museum in order to find the ledger. If you lost it while touring the museum and it wasn't back on the desk, then it must be in one of the galleries. Stay here and we will return to see you when we have found it, and not a word of it to the director.
Certainly, sir. With many thanks, I will continue to do my inventory and await you.
Okay.
Tell me, young man, would you happen to have a blueprint of the building in order to facilitate the task at hand?
Yeah.
Yes, yes. Where did I put it? Oh, yes, here it is.
Ah.
Farewell, Palinor.
Okay, now, we have... National Gallery of Paint. Ah, now we have a map. So we have, this is where we're at the entrance hall. That's the director's office. Spanish gallery. French gallery. English gallery. Dutch gallery. Flemish gallery. Italian gallery. German gallery. And over here is no admittance to the public. Okay. So, we'll start with our tour of... We shall go up to the... Okay, Watson's coming along. So, let's go to Spanish Gallery.
The Spanish Painter's Gallery.
Yes. I think this is where they did a good job
La Tela Real by the great Spanish master Diego Velazquez, 1599 to 1660, painted from the golden century of Spain. It depicts a royal boar hunt.
Mm-hmm.
The Vendramin family venerating a relic of the True Cross by Titian, a Venetian painter, died in 1576, leader of the 16th century Venetian school of the Cinquecento.
Yes, very true.
Jacob with a Flock of Laban by Josep de Ribera, also called Lo Spagnoletto, or the Little Spaniard, because of his high height. Christ healing the paralytic at the Pool of Bethesda by Murillo, one of the most important figures in Baroque painting in Spain during the 18th century.
It's interesting you can hear all
Christ
this information.
Christ driving the traders from the temple, canvassed by the Spanish master El Greco. A peasant boy leaning on a sill by Bartolomé Esteban Murillo, 1672. The Toilet of Venus by Diego Velázquez, who was considered along with Francisco Goya and El Greco as one of the greatest artists in all of Spanish history. An apostle to Josep de Ribera, 1591-1662.
It's interesting to find out some of this stuff.
Vecellio. Better known as Titian, is an allegory on prudence. It rereads from the past, the man of the present, and prudence is the man of the peril of the future. Wise advice.
Indeed.
The Lamentation of the Dead Christ, by Josep de Ribera, a Tennessee painter. A lovely painting by Murillo. Impressive.
Yes.
And the name of Jesus, El Greco, 1641-1614, Spanish painter, created the Roman school.
Now, I wonder if this was actually,
French painter's gallery.
And this is Spanish painter's gallery. So, the French painter's gallery.
A portrait of Madame Noisier, by Jesus, who is also a violinist on the side, like myself. Monsieur de Norvins, portrayed by Jean-Auguste Dominique Ingres, 1780-1876.
Yes.
The Billet Doux, by François Boucher.
Now, I wonder if this is actually how that gallery is set up in England.
A beautiful landscape
as well as
by
all
Boucher,
the, as all the paintings.
A marvelous color, age my land.
Yes.
The Battle of Genappe, by Horace Vernet, one of the victories of the French Revolution. The Battle of the Hanau, which took place in 1813, the beginning of the end for Napoleon despite this victory.
Oh, another one.
Watson, come quickly.
What is it, Holmes? What have you found?
A painting by my great uncle, Horace Vernet. I had forgotten that his work could be found here.
Oh,
it
Vernet.
It is certainly this ancestor to whom Lupin made reference in his letter. Such talent, don't you think?
Who? Lupin?
No, Vernet. Albeit Lupin also, but in a different field.
Okay. Now, that's Napoleon.
The Emperor Napoleon I, or Bonaparte as we English prefer, painted by Horace Vernet.
Wow.
The Scale of Love by Jean-Antoine Watteau. Born in 1684, died in 1721. French painter, one of the first in the Rococo style, inspired by the Commedia dell'arte, who loved to depict theatre and festivities in his paintings. Perfect Harmony by Jean-Antoine Watteau. A canvas by Nicolas Poussin that tells of the discovery of Moses. Very nice. The Adoration of the Golden Calf by Nicolas Poussin, a classical French painter from the 17th century who spent most of his productive career not in Paris, but in Rome, on the fringes of the prominent schools of the era.
I think that's our ledger.
Jacques Cazot, portrayed by Jean-Baptiste Peronneau, born around 1715, died 1783.
Well, it seems that we've found the famous ledger. It's written in shorthand, and there are hundreds of entries. Let's bring it to the archivist.
And we will.
The Triumph of Pan by Nicolas Poussin.
And?
A Canvas by Joseph Vernet, my great-great-uncle. Horace Vernet, my ancestor. Magnificent, this landscape at sunset.
What's that?
Portrait of a Woman by Peronneau, French School, pastel on paper. French Painters Gallery.
Mm-hmm. Now this is, I think, the English Painters Hall. And we're going to...
Thomas Gainsborough, one of the most famous English portrait and landscape painters. A magnificent landscape. Margate from the Sea by William Turner. A canvas by William Turner, the painter of light. John Constable, he managed to turn a boring part of England into a place you'd almost want to visit. The Painter's Daughters Chasing a Butterfly by Thomas Gainsborough. Sun Rising Through Vapor by... The Evening Star by William Turner.
Yeah, I'm not going to...
Mr. and Mrs. Andrews by...
But I think it's important to look at all paintings.
Lord Heathfield of Gibraltar. Dr. Ralph Schomburg by Thomas Gainsborough, 1727. A canvas by Sir Reynolds. Colonel Tarleton, hero of the British forces during the American War of Independence. Queen Charlotte, painted by Sir Thomas Lawrence, an 18th century painter. Lady Coburn and her three eldest sons by Sir Reynolds. Self-portrait by William Turner, born in 1775. Extraordinary English.
Okay.
English Painters Hall.
Now if we go in here. Dutch paintings.
Dutch gallery. A young woman seated at a virgin. A canvas by Gerard Terborch. View of the Westerkerk, Amsterdam. A terrible naval battle scene. A work by Jan Steen. Paint Willem van der Velde. A winter scene with skaters near a castle by Averkamp.
You know, it's nice to look at all these paintings. A winter scene with skaters. I did not want to do that.
The Countryside, painted by Salomon van Roosdael, born in the first few years. Jacob van Roosdael. A painting by Rembrandt, the sum of his works in... Self-portrait at the age of 63 by Rembrandt. An architectural fantasy, painted... A river scene with a Dutch yacht by Van der Capelle.
So I have no doubt that all these paintings are very real.
The swearing of the oath.
Anyone who sees this,
a beach scene with fishermen by
Lugolf. I wonder if you could tell me if they actually have all these paintings in that museum.
The Flemish artists are found here. A work by David Teniers. Rubens, The Judgment of Paris. What a dilemma. Paris had to choose between one of the three divinities, Venus, Juno, or Minerva, and anger the other two in the process.
There was nothing to it but choose all three.
Peace and War, Rubens, The Old Master, painting peasants at archery. David Teniers, the younger, 1610 to 1690. The Flemish artists are found here.
A lot of grief.
The Balby Children by Van Dyck. Lady Elizabeth Thimbleby and Viscountess Andover. Van Dyck in person. This artist had a huge influence on English portraitists. He is considered to be the... A Sunset by Rubens. Look, a white horse standing by a sleeping man by Peter Van... Hearing, canvas by Gonzales... Sight, portrait of Robert Van... A Family Group by Gonzales Cox... Portrait of a boy holding a rose.
Oh, that's a surreal painting.
Canvas painted around 1620. Unknown artist from the Flemish school. Portrait of a man. Canvas loaned to the museum. Work of an unknown artist, dating between 1645 and 1655. The Gallery of Italian Works. Adoration of the Kings by... Must you see it to believe? The Incredulity of St. Thomas. St. Catherine of Alexandria. The Origin of the Milky Way, painted around 1570. A painting by Veronese, the family of Darius before Alexander. canvas by Orazio.
I admit this might be boring to some people, but...
A study by Tiepolo. The Virgin of the Rocks, famous canvas painted between 1491 and 1508 by Leonardo da Vinci.
Yes, I've heard of that one.
Multidisciplinary man, artist, scientist...
You speak of yourself, Holmes?
This painting depicts the gods Venus and Mars by Botticelli. This painting was exhibited for the first time in 1874 in the National Gallery. St. Catherine of Alexandria by The Assassination of St. Peter Martyr, The Supper at Emmaus.
Mm-hmm.
The Gallery of Italian Works.
And I look at these over here?
Painting by Lorenzo Lotto, born around 1480. St. Catherine of Alexandria. Ah, Venice, La Serenissima. This one from 1740 by Canaletto.
Okay, now we look through all those, and over here... No, that's a door.
Closed.
Closed. Dag nubbit.
Closed.
Yes, they're closed.
Closed.
Closed. Gosh, yeah. Ah, see here.
German gallery. There's no inscription here. I'll speak to the director, perhaps. Canvas by Adam Elsheimer. A work that just exudes the joy of living. Tobias and the Archangel Raphael by... Judith in the Tent of Holofernes by Johann Liss, 1595 to 1631. What will she do with that head?
No idea.
The Virgin and Child by Albrecht Dürer, 1471 to 50. The Ambassadors, 1533 by Hans Holbein. The St. Paul on Malta by Adam Elsheimer. St. Catherine of Alexandria. Charity by Lucan Cranach the Elder. Portrait of a Woman by Lucas Cranach. Cranach's style has such ambience, he depicts a Cranach. The painter's father, Albrecht Dürer. Hans Holbein the Younger died of the German gallery.
You know, we have now taken a look at every damn painting in the building. Alrighty.
Yes, Mr. Holmes?
Oh, schnaggies.
Farewell, Palinor.
Okay. Now!
Yes, Mr. Holmes?
The ledger.
Here is your ledger, my friend.
You found it! Many thanks. You won't say anything to Sir Pointer.
Rest assured, are you familiar with how the entries are written? Everything seems to be abbreviated.
I understand how to locate a thematic group and how to read a description, but I am struggling with the location codes.
It's better than nothing at the moment. We're searching for a painting that has a connection to the Battle of Trafalgar.
Depicting what exactly?
According to this poem, it could be...
Are you sure? It means nothing.
Ship.
Yes, Mr. Holmes?
It might refer to a boat. Its master was Admiral Nelson, and the thief wanted to run it aground. Moreover, the boat would have a French name.
Wait, I have a suggestion. A very popular painting, symbolic even, The Fighting Temeraire, a Turner. In this painting, Turner is described as having mastered painting techniques, and it is one of the most beautiful English paintings of all time. The subject, a boat by the French name of Temeraire, was involved in the Battle of Trafalgar and distinguished itself by protecting Victory, the flagship on board which was...
Victory, did you say?
Yes, Admiral Nelson was on board. Temeraire received a special distinction, but I am not certain of which. The painting shows it being towed to the breaker's yard, I believe.
Ah!
Where would I find it?
I don't know. You would have to search through the English works of this century near the west section of the gallery.
My thanks, Palinor. Come, Watson, let's take a look at the painting.
I'm sure Watson will keep up with me. Okay, so we have to look at a ship. There it is!
Here's what I've been looking for.
So we already looked at it.
The Fighting Temeraire. Splendid. What do you think?
I agree, it's splendid. The existence of this painting would seem to give credit to this whole affair.
As long as this painting remains on this wall, this letter, even if it is eloquent and provocative, is nothing more than a letter. It is possible that all of this could be a hoax with no substance whatsoever. We will know soon enough, as the theft will have to take place tonight.
We must warn the museum's director, Holmes.
You are correct, Watson. Shall we?
So now it is time to go warn the director. Yep.
Fantastic! Yep. Superb!
There, Maestro. I believe that everything is settled.
This collaboration will be my crowning glory, my masterpiece. Merci!
I have finished the inventory of the works of art, Director. Oh, and I have the pleasure of introducing the great detective Sherlock Holmes and his companion, Dr. Watson.
Good day, gentlemen. It's with pleasure that I welcome you to our gallery. Mm-hmm. I trust that you are here for pleasure and not business?
I'm afraid that is not the case.
Oh.
When it is no longer a matter of art, the artist must make his excuses. Messieurs, until we meet again, no need to accompany me. I know the way.
My apologies, gentlemen. Have you been waiting long?
Mr. Palinor was able to answer all of our most urgent questions. Tell me, who was that man who just left?
That was Horace Valmont, a French painter. One of the best, seemingly. His letters of recommendation come from some of the grandest salons in Paris.
Let's take a look, Watson.
Yes, he's very avant-garde. He heard that we were showing the works of modern painters during our temporary exhibitions. He has loaned us a number of paintings and has promised to donate those that have the greatest success to the museum.
Interesting. Just in time. And the Frenchman, Watson?
Gone?
Director, this is Inspector Lestrade from Scotland Yard. Lestrade, this is the director of the National Gallery, Sir Poynter, and his assistant, Mr. Palinor. Lestrade, would you have your constable on duty guard the entrance and make sure that nobody comes into the museum? Director, is there anything else?
No, but...
If you would care to follow me, I'll show you what the motivation behind all of this is. The reason for this little gathering is this letter that I received at my lodgings this morning. Without getting into too much detail, it claims that this painting, The Fighting Temeraire, will be stolen tonight.
Pardon?
There now. It's because of a letter that you've disturbed me. You believe that?
I would never have taken the liberty to disturb you if this letter, the authenticity of which I must admit hasn't been completely confirmed, was not written by the one and only Arsene Lupin.
Arsene Lupin?
Arsene Lupin?
Us? Arsenal? Who? Lou? What?
Arsene Lupin, the most wanted cat burglar in the world. We will know soon enough whether or not this letter is a fake or if I had reason to disturb you, Lestrade. But you must understand that we couldn't take even the slightest chance.
Perhaps. Why not simply put this thing under lock and key in the bank or at Scotland Yard?
We cannot risk storing the painting in an improper environment or to entrust it to anyone who calls it a... thing.
All that would achieve would be to shift the problem. This painting is priceless. Beware he who would harm it. What I propose, Lestrade, is to do a tour of the museum with Sir Poynter in order to check any possible points of break and entry, and leave two men on duty here tonight. In addition, Director,
you must
close the museum to the public and not let anyone else in.
If you feel it's necessary.
And you, Holmes?
I'll pass by tomorrow at dawn. We'll know then what we're up against. Should the unthinkable have occurred, I insist that nothing is touched until I arrive. Is that clear? Let's be off, Watson.
All right.
Listen, Inspector, I have a lot of work to take care of. It would be better if I leave you to do a tour by yourself. You are, after all, a professional. Here are the keys to all of the locked doors. If you need me, I'll be in my office.
And now
well, I best inspect the museum to find any of Lupin's possible exits, including mice holes.
Yeah. What's this?
Nothing to report.
Nothing to report.
We need a cannon to force this door down. The lock is too big to be jimmied, and I'll leave a man on duty in place. If Lupin does come, it won't be that way.
Yeah. Okay. Oh!
It's dark in this box room. Good. No windows. No possible entry.
No. I didn't hear close. Okay. Oh. Oh, I think I know what this is. This is an art restoration room.
There is a possible entry. If someone wanted to descend from the roof here, he'd need a lot of time, and it wouldn't be a quiet business. But I'd be wise to leave a man on duty here, and he will signal the alarm at any suspicious movement coming from the roof. Arsene Lupin, it's you and I now.
Yeah. All right. Italian gallery.
No exits on this side. Nothing to report.
Okay.
No exits on this side. Nothing to report.
Okay, in here. Nothing there. Nothing here. And...
No exits on this side. Nothing to report.
Okay.
That chap must have been rip-roaring drunk when he painted that one. No exits on this side. Nothing to report.
Okay. Okay, and that checks that one, and we'll look in here. Don't look anything. Okay, I think we've checked everything. So let's go talk to the director. And point there. Alright.
I will make sure there are no windows, and therefore ways in. Here.
Do your work. I will draw a map for you, Inspector.
Wait for tonight.
All right.
There. The director and his underling have left. Time for us to play now. It could be that this whole robbery is nothing but nonsense. If not, we are prepared. And this Lupin will play right into our hands. I'll lock the main door to the museum, and you will be locked in. Jeffries is on duty in Trafalgar Square, and the yard is nearby. Nothing to worry about there. The doors leading in will be locked. But you will each have everything you need to open them. Stay hidden and cover your light so you cannot be seen from the roof. Mm-hmm. You, Lockhart, will be stationed near the painting itself. At the least provocation, go down to the entrance and sound the alarm. The walls are too thick, so you will have to go down for your whistle to be heard. In case of real trouble, be sure to fire with deadly accuracy. Because if you even graze one of the paintings, your great-grandchildren will still be paying off your debts.
Yep.
Finally, You'll just have to be content with your lanterns. Gas is too expensive.
Let's go, man. Keep your wits about you. You'll be relieved at 4 a.m.
All right, later. What's that? Oh! Now that's clever. What's he doing? The other guy's in here. Because there's a light in there. And there is Lupin.
Go on, you dangerous dodger. You have work to do.
The constable was indeed asked to deliver us a letter. It's from Lestrade.
Nothing good can come from such urgency.
Indeed, Holmes.
This time, without doubt,
the painting has disappeared. According to what he's written, they've turned the National Gallery upside down looking for it. Our presence is required immediately.
Well, Watson, the game is afoot.
Should we not have enlisted men from the force to protect the painting?
I think that a whole brigade could not have stopped Lupin. And, of course, we can now be certain that it was he who was behind the theft. First and foremost, the police have a city and lives to protect, and we must respect that.
Yep.
Watson, a hansom will be hard to find at this hour, and Billy, our page, is sick. Would you be so good as to flag one down while I take a moment to reread this letter?
Yesterday, I was a doctor, and now I've become a valet.
All right, and at this point, we're going to save the game. And we will continue this next time, as we will meet some other characters that will come into play. Including, well, I can tell you for a fact that we have already met Lupin. Now, can you figure out who he was? And we will meet him in another guise in the next installment. I have played this before, so I do remember certain things. And, as always, you can check out the previous part, as well as the other games that were set chronologically before this. That being Sherlock Holmes versus Jack the Ripper, Sherlock Holmes The Awakened, and Sherlock Holmes Crimes and Punishment. I am also working my way through other games. I am working my way through Alien Isolation, getting closer and closer to the end of that. I am also working my way through several LucasArts titles, currently working on Escape from Monkey Island, the fourth game released, and eventually I will get the fifth title that, quote, closes out the series, Tales from Monkey Island, which is a Telltale game, so that'll be a different experience. I'm also working my way through games with Call of Cthulhu in the name, currently working on Call of Cthulhu, Dark Corners of the Earth. I do a series of runs through the game of Monstrum. And I am working my way through the Myst series, currently working on the last game in the Myst series, Myst 5, End of Ages. And I am working my way through several Sierra titles, currently working through Shivers 2, Harvest of Souls. And there's some other games up on the channel that you may want to check out. The playthrough's up. Take care, everyone, and have a good day. And next time around, we will find out what has been done at the museum. Bye.